Have you heard the term high-performance CPR? Or maybe pit crew CPR? Well, my name is Roy Shaw, licensed paramedic, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about it and give my take on what I think about it. Pit crew or high-performance CPR was designed for EMS professionals. As the name implies, pit crew CPR is inspired by the well-choreographed crews who get race cars back on the track in a hurry. Pit crew CPR emphasizes starting chest compressions as soon as possible, without interruptions. Although specific details will vary slightly from region to region, the primary goals of pit crew or high-performance CPR are basically the same. The primary goals are to minimally interrupt chest compressions, provide early defibrillation, and provide airway support. Advanced life support providers should use capnography to identify the return of circulation. Now, the big difference between a simple team approach to CPR and pit crew CPR is that everybody knows what their assignment is based on when they walk through the door. The first rescuer to arrive confirms that there's no pulse and initiates continuous chest compressions. Now, the second emergency responder takes the position on the other side of the patient's chest and then prepares an AED or defibrillator. This person should turn on the AED or defibrillator and attach the pads while compressions continue. Now, during that time, the third responder takes the position at the patient's head, assembles the BVM with oxygen, attaches capnography between the mask and the bag, and then inserts an OPA. Now, as soon as a shockable rhythm has been detected, the AED or defibrillator charges and the first shock is delivered. Immediately after the first shock, the second rescuer takes over compressions. You should now switch to 30-2 with the CPR. The rescuer at the head should pay attention to the capnography end tidal CO2 reading. Now, what does this mean from a paramedic standpoint? Good, effective care is what it means to me. This is something that we're trained to do all the time as EMS professionals, but unfortunately, from region to region, you can have varying levels of compliance. So I think it's a great idea that some high-speed, low-drag EMS professionals believe that there's better outcomes achievable for those in cardiac arrest if we choreograph our efforts more concisely and become better effective responders. I say hats off to those who are thinking about it and starting to promote it, because good care equals saved lives, and you always want to do that.